Okay, salut, it's Alex. So today is about solving one of my problems. Before we do that, let me give you some context. You see, I consider myself as a committed defender of the holistic approach to cooking. Cooking has to be considered as a whole concept. Let me show you what I mean. So this is you, or anybody that wants to be fed. My job could be reduced to that part and that part only. Feed people, make people eat. Of course, before I can feed people, I need to prep the food, get the food, think the food. I also need to deal with the food. Technically, a video or a recipe is not exactly tangible food. Not even not exactly, it's not. But in many ways, I'm feeding your soul, your appetite for food. So I'm feeding something. Now, obviously, within this highly scientific diagram stand an infinite number of problems that I need to tackle eventually. Season, sustainability, the shopping technique, social leftovers, health feedback situation, which basically consists of rough criticizing made by those who just remain seated at the table while doing nothing. Way too many problems. Of course, I can't deal with all of them at the same time, but in this video, I will at least address one, the grocery bag conundrum. I'm trying to build something that would be food friendly, that's the main purpose, but that would also double as a daily bag for me. Breaking news, I'm not the only one using a grocery bag when, you know, shopping at the store. So I ask you guys on Instagram story, what actually is your shopping bag? And these are the answers I got. So I've got myself a very wide selection of grocery bags. So I suggest we start with the most obvious one. The plastic bag. It's compact, light, very resistant, inexpensive, it's basically free. But, and there is a big but. It is not recyclable. The reusable plastic bag. It can be very compact, beautifully designed. Yeah. Most supermarkets or stores just accept to change it if yours gets ruined. But then I wonder what they do with it. This one is made out of plastic, but there is a thermal insulation inside. It's just a picture of the person who's gonna die if you throw it away. Just a quick word about the plastic bag. I'm not super fan of them. I've been using them in the past. Anyway, I'm trying to be a better person, okay? I'm gonna reach out to a friend, Dave Hackens, who started like years ago a global initiative to just put all the trashed plastic to good use. It's called Precious Plastic. I will post a link in the description box down below. Absolutely amazing. But for the moment, let's just ask the guy. Hey Dave, what's up? It's Alex. Any chance you could tell me how wrong a plastic bag is?
So here's the thing with plastic bags, Alex. You quickly get them in a store or something, but they stay around on planet for hundreds of years, floating around into the oceans or going to landfills, or they're getting burned. And it's just a waste of material. And you could recycle them, but that still takes a lot of energy and effort to do it. Just for the few seconds you want to use that bag. So next time you're in a store, don't get a plastic bag, get a reusable one. I don't know, fill it up in your hands, your pockets, but whatever you do, do not get that plastic bag.
Next, the classic tote bags, plural. I got many. You've got the super light version, shameful handles. Oh, I'm truly sorry, YouTube, but this is not a good tote bag. Then you've got the super heavy duty tote bag, but the handles are too short. It's way too high and not wide enough. My favorite tote bag ever. Falls on the shoulder just perfectly. It's super solid. You can basically put it in your pocket. The problem with this one is that you've got no compartment inside. Where do I put my smartphone? We also need to take into account regular bags, like backpacks or bags. This is my backpack. It's extremely solid. It has a great volume inside, but it's heavy. That's probably the only problem of this backpack. Love this backpack. I would be very annoyed if the fish or the chicken were to just leak inside this bag. Great thing about this bag, you've got a zipper. It has a great inner volume. I think it can hold loads of weight. It's not super foldable. Guys, I'm in a shop doing my shopping. Also, one of the cons of using a bag like this one when you're doing shopping, it feels like you're doing shoplifting. At the end of the day, I've got two serious candidates. This would be perfect for a daily use. This is only great to go to the grocery store. You only need one bag, your bag. For the moment, I don't have the perfect solution, but trust me, I have tracks. First, the bag must be big. It's probably not the best idea to use my beloved Japanese bowl, but I know how to... That's a big bag. Second feature, the bag must be strong. It will definitely be a challenge to make it as strong as possible while making it as light as possible. Fourth, it should be pocketable. Bing! Five, recyclable. Now number six, this bag should be like this watch. Simple, efficient, clean, understandable. The food features now. Obviously, and let me tell you that the food features are the most interesting one. This is not a comfortable I'm just fed up with those cutting handles. Meat, leek, veg, squished, and then leek, can, squishers, fragile stuff, your smartphone, keys. And because of all those type of groceries, there needs to be a compartment system inside this bag. I want some thermal insulation. I'm thinking of insulating the whole bag and adding a closing system on top. I want it definitely weatherproof. Because we are dealing with foods, loads of food, I want the whole thing to be washable. Wash. Sorry to interrupt, guys, but this is me, Alex, from the next episode. And I'm just literally putting the finishing touches to this beta early version of the ultimate grocery bag. This is so exciting, guys, look at this. It's not super strong. Look at this, guys, whatever, it's great. Oh, look at this. I basically made a not weatherproofed, not waterproof, not insulated, not compartmentalized tote bag. Start again. Okay, so guys, that's it for this episode. I think you have now a good varnish on the overall concept that I want to achieve right there. Of course, I'm really waiting for your feedback on this. I think we can make something amazing. Amazing is the basement, okay? And I want to go to the ceiling. So in the next episode, I will start building a prototype. So I'm really looking to your feedback in the comments down below. As always, if you enjoyed this episode, then please give it a big thumbs up and share that everywhere. Insta, Face, Twitter really helps me a lot. Spread it like butter. Last people, click subscribe because I make new videos every week. It's always about food. I mean, this is a grocery bag. So it's in the meantime, take care. Bye bye. Salut. And I need to get a sewing machine.